The most famous of the group that broke the German Enigma machine codes was Alan Turing. He was one of those people who seemed to be one step ahead of the rest of us in the fields of math and science. He and the team at Bletchley Park, a top-secret center dedicated to code-breaking during the war, helped turn the tide of the conflict by decrypting the Nazis' most difficult codes. Turing was born in 1912, the second of two brothers. As a young man, Turing was incredibly intelligent and athletically gifted. He rode his bike everywhere. He rode 60 miles to his boarding school on his first day, stuck far away by a train strike. He made it on time. The school didn't always recognize Turing's talents. He was almost stopped from taking the school certificate due to concerns that he would fail. While he excelled in science, his headmaster said, "If he is to be solely a scientific specialist, he is wasting his time at public school." In 1928, Turing met a new classmate called Christopher Morcom. The two young men became very close friends. They would also explore intellectual problems in physics and maths together. They would be seen passing notes to each other during class. The two boys were very close, and at this time, Alan supposedly developed a crush on Christopher. Their friendship was not to last, though, as in 1930, when Alan was 17 years old, Christopher died of tuberculosis. After his friend's death, Alan threw himself into trying to unravel the nature of consciousness and how it was linked to matter. This led Alan to think about the concept of the mind as a machine that could be recreated with mathematical logic. Turing attended King's College, Cambridge. He received a distinguished degree in 1934 and a fellowship of King's College in 1935. He attended Princeton University for a couple of years, returning to England just prior to the war. As war broke out in Europe in 1939, Turing went to work for the British cryptanalytic headquarters at Bletchley Park. The people at Bletchley Park worked 24 hours a day to break a variety of German codes and give the Allies prior knowledge of German intentions to be used on the battlefield, skies and oceans, and see inside the German Reich to try and understand the workings of the murderous regime. At Bletchley, Turing was known to be somewhat eccentric. He would ride to work in a gas mask to protect him from pollen. His bike had a bad chain, and instead of replacing it, he kept time in his head counting out the pedal rotations it would take before it fell off, then repairing it before it did. He would also chain his mug to a radiator to avoid it getting taken by someone else. In Hut 8, Turing, who was always referred to as Prof, and his team elaborated upon the early computer designed by Poles working to break the German Enigma machine codes. With this work, and Turing's ability to see patterns and equations, the team in Hut 8 began to break additional German codes. Most famously, the U-boat codes, which ordered the German submarine fleet towards their victims and hunting grounds. As the war progressed and the ciphers became more complex, Turing and the team at Bletchley invented more complicated machines to rapidly decrypt the German communications. At its peak, Bletchley was decrypting 84,000 communications each month. After World War II, Winston Churchill called the submarine threat the only thing that really scared him during the war. Though many worked on this problem and others, without Alan Turing, the solution to the problem might have taken much longer, time which the Allies did not have, or may not have even happened at all. His work undoubtedly shortened the war and saved many lives. It also laid the groundwork for the technological age we live in today. For his work during the war, Turing was awarded the Order of the British Empire by the King. But this, like his work, remained secret for years. Turing was gay, and in the decades before its decriminalization in 1967, homosexuality was persecuted and prosecuted in England as well as in many other nations. After World War II and as the Cold War began to heat up, Turing was arrested for gross indecency. Taking a guilty plea, Turing was offered prison or conditional probation. He took probation. As a condition of the probation, he had to take large doses of hormone therapy. The aim was to render him physically incapable of having sex, and the treatment had terrible side effects on his health and well-being. After his conviction, he was barred from doing any further government work, and his security clearance was revoked. His past was subject to investigation, as the authorities were worried that his homosexuality could have been used as blackmail by the Soviet Union, no evidence of which has ever been found. On June 8, 1952, Turing's housekeeper found his body. A half-eaten apple, which was never checked for poison, and a to-do list was by his bedside. The official cause of death was suicide, though many have cast doubt upon this conclusion. In the years following his death, Turing's work became more and more recognized by the public, and a groundswell of support to rectify the injustice of Turing's life came to the fore. In 2009, after intense lobbying, the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom made an apology for the treatment of Turing. But he was not officially pardoned. The UK Justice Minister said that a pardon was not considered appropriate as Alan Turing was properly convicted of what at the time was a criminal offence. In 2012, many influential people, including Stephen Hawking, lobbied the UK government to officially pardon Turing.
One of the most brilliant mathematicians of the modern era, yet successive governments seem incapable of forgiving his conviction for the then crime of being a homosexual.
In 2013, the Queen gave Turing a royal pardon. The Prime Minister David Cameron said his actions saved countless lives. He also left a remarkable national legacy through his substantial scientific achievements, often being referred to as the father of modern computing. Stephen Fry said at the time, at bloody last, next step a banknote if there's any justice. In 2014, the movie The Imitation Game, starring Benedict Cumberbatch and Keira Knightley, was released, depicting Turing's struggles and lending impetus to a new realization of his genius and knowledge of his persecution. In June 2019, the British government announced that Turing's likeness would be placed on the £50 note. A small comfort to those who knew and supported Turing, the note contains an appropriately enigmatic quote from Turing. "This is only a foretaste of what is to come, and only the shadow of what is going to be."